You all know I don't do 10-minute videos. However, comma, this one is a double feature. First is my cast versus real life, and then the real true story afterwards. Isaac Wright Jr. became the first and only person in U.S. history to have been sentenced to life in prison, securing his own release and exoneration, and then being granted a license to practice law by the very court that condemned him. So what did he actually do to be thrown in jail for life? He was born January 23, 1962, in Orlando, Florida, to Isaac Wright Sr. and Sandra B. Wright. Together, they had a total of 6 children, 5 boys and 1 girl. His father was active duty military and was away from home often, leaving his wife to hold down the fort and make sure the kids were taken care of. Wright stayed out of trouble in his youth and attended Berkeley High School in South Carolina. Now, let us straighten out the facts from fiction in the ABC TV show For Life, starring Nicholas Pinnock as Aaron Wallace, aka the real Isaac Wright Jr. No, Isaac Wright Jr. was an independent record producer. In the late 80s, he became a talent manager and owned an independent record label called Express Records. A couple of years later, he co-created the girl group The Cover Girls that included his wife Sunshine. The group has several hit songs in the late 80s and early 90s. Some of their music videos can still be found on YouTube. Yes, the charges against the character on the TV show are similar to the charges against Isaac Wright Jr. in real life, but they seem to have been trimmed down a little for the show. In real life, he was charged with 18 counts, including leading a drug trafficking network, maintaining or operating a narcotics production facility, possession of cocaine with intent to distribute, and conspiracy to distribute cocaine. At the time of his arrest, the authorities had alleged that Wright was making $30,000 a day from dealing cocaine to residents of New Jersey. We now know that, quote unquote, the authorities, including other attorneys and police officers, were lying, trumping up charges against Wright. All because of one man, Nicholas L. Bissell, played by actor Boris McGiver. More on that clown later. Instead of paying a lawyer, he decided to represent himself at his trial. With only a high school diploma at the time, it's a decision that he now calls insane, and was also interviewed saying, "I wasn't going to pay somebody to send me to prison." Upon further research, we learned that he was convicted of all 18 charges and given life in prison for the drug kingpin charge. As part of his sentence, Isaac would only become eligible for parole after serving 30 years. No, this is one of the more significant differences between ABC's For Life TV show and the true story. The real Isaac Wright Jr. didn't begin his formal education until after he was released from prison. This was around the fall of 1998. It was then that he began attending Thomas Edison State University in Trenton for 4 years as an undergraduate. He graduated from college in 2002 and then went to law school at St. Thomas University in Miami in 2004. Now, it is true that while in prison, he taught himself law and helped other inmates get released or their sentence reduced, but he acted as a paralegal, not a lawyer. This doesn't necessarily make what he was able to accomplish any less significant. Instead of arguing cases in the court, like on the show, he composed briefs and handed them off to lawyers on the outside. Often, inmates had gotten public defenders or cheap lawyers, and Wright was essentially the brains behind their defense. Yes, after educating himself in New Jersey law, Isaac came up with a legal strategy to help another inmate's kingpin charge get removed. He authored a defense pro se brief going after the kingpin jury instructions in State v. Alexander, 136 New Jersey 563 from 1994. Wright's arguments were successful, and he used the ruling in Alexander to get his own kingpin conviction reversed. Even the then assistant Somerset County prosecutor assigned to make sure Wright stayed behind bars called him highly intelligent and a better brief writer than most attorneys he'd encountered. Once Wright got the kingpin charge and his life sentence removed, he was still facing 17 other charges that amounted to 70 years in prison. He was sentenced in 1991 and only spent 7.5 years in New Jersey State Prison. Yep, he had been married to his wife Sunshine Wright before entering prison. In researching the true story behind For Life, we discovered that they indeed went through a divorce while he was still in prison. This is where I introduce you to the Somerset County, New Jersey prosecutor, Nicholas Bissell Jr. and all his shenanigans. Nick Bissell grew up in Woodbridge Township, New Jersey, and later moved to Somerville, New Jersey. There he entered private practice, then worked as a part-time judge before becoming an assistant prosecutor for Somerset County. He was appointed county prosecutor in 1982 by Tom Keene, the governor of New Jersey, and he held that position for 13 years. His specialty was civil forfeiture. At one point, the value of the assets he seized were the highest in the state, even though Somerset County is the 8th smallest county in New Jersey. He had some people concerned that he wasn't doing things on the up and up, but they didn't know just how right they were. On May 10, 1990, a man named James Guffrey was arrested on charges of selling $700 worth of cocaine. Bissell said he would drop the man's charges if he forfeited two plots of land to the prosecutor's office valued at $174,000. James agreed, and they were sold at auction below their appraised value to a friend of Bissell's chief of detectives. Although James had his charges dropped, he felt like he still had an axe to grind with Nick Bissell. So James contacted the IRS and the FBI. And what happened next is why everybody knows, or should know, not to mess with them alphabet boys.
A federal jury convicts former Somerset County prosecutor and his wife on all criminal counts.
Forensic accountants with the IRS discovered that Bissell skimmed cash from a gas station of which he was part owner. The FBI discovered that Bissell was destroying suspects' written requests for lawyers and also found out that he threatened to frame his own gasoline wholesaler with cocaine possession if he didn't lie for him in court. When it was all said and done, in September 1995, Bissell was indicted on 30 federal charges of mail fraud, tax evasion, and abuse of power. He was also fired by the governor, Christine Whitman. In May 1996, he was convicted on all charges and faced a minimum sentence of 6 to 8 years in federal prison. He was released under the condition that he wear an electronic bracelet until he was sentenced. He cut it off on November 18, 1996, and fled to Nevada, leaving a note with his intentions to commit suicide, but he was tracked by his cell phone. 8 days later, U.S. Marshals found him in a cheap motel in Nevada. As officers broke down his door, he stuck a 45 in his mouth and said to hell with it, instead of turning himself in and facing a 6 to 8 year sentence. During a 1996 evidentiary hearing, Isaac cross-examined Detective James Dugan and was able to get him to admit to misconduct in his case. Dugan's admission of guilt lifted the veil of the broad level of corruption in Wright's case, in addition to the efforts to cover it up. The disgraced detective pled guilty to official misconduct so that he could avoid prison time. Immediately, it became clear that Somerset County's head prosecutor, Nicholas L. Bissell Jr., was the orchestrator of the misconduct. Although Isaac spent years working on his own case as a prison paralegal, he still wasn't able to secure his freedom entirely on his own. He did so with the help of his own lawyer, Francis Hartman. On December 17, 1996, Isaac was released on a bail of $250,000, a sum raised by his supporters and friends. A different judge ordered a new trial, but the new prosecutor decided to delay Isaac's retrial indefinitely. Also, it was later found that Michael Imbriani, the original judge who presided over Isaac's trial, was corrupt. He was involved in the plot to lock Isaac in prison. Imbriani was removed from the bench and ended up going to jail on theft charges. As of 2022, Wright is an attorney at a full-service law firm, Hunt, Hamlin, and Ridley, located in Newark, New Jersey. He's also making up for lost time with his daughter.